Hello Overclockers, in this video I'm going to be showing you how to remove and reinstall a graphics card. Reseating the GPU in your system is a simple troubleshooting step that can save you a lot of time if your PC has an unfortunate display error. The idea is to eliminate any simple causes before spending money on a hardware replacement or submitting an RMA. You might also find this video useful if you're installing a brand new graphics card upgrade. Remember to shut down, turn off and unplug your PC, including your display beforehand, and let's get started. The first step is to remove the side panel and then identify your video card. Pretty much every gaming PC will come with a discrete GPU, and it's easy to spot as it's the big large component right in the middle. It will likely have several fans and might even have power cables sticking out of it, just like this one. Next, you'll want to remove the screws holding the graphics card in place. Different cases might have the screws either inside or outside the case. They could also be in a cover around the back here somewhere. However, they will always be over here on the left-hand side somewhere. You might also see other screws as well. You just want to ignore these ones and focus on the ones that are holding the metal plate on the back of your graphics card in place. There could be one, two, or three of them. So slowly undo them while supporting the weight of your graphics card. Most modern graphics cards will have external power connectors from your power supply. There might be one, two, or even three, just like these here. If you are reseating the graphics card, you might find that there's enough slack that you can actually leave these plugged in. Like this graphics card, I'd probably be tempted not to actually undo them if I was simply reseating. But if you're upgrading or everything is tight and neatly cable managed, you will want to remove them before unseating the card. There's a small clip on one side and you simply push it down and pull it out. I find that they can be a little bit stiff sometimes, so maybe give it a wiggle while supporting your graphics card. Finally, the only thing holding your graphics card in place is a small clip on the PCIe slot on your motherboard. You can see it here from the top down, and all you have to do if you have small hands is reach in and push it down with your finger. If things are a little bit tighter, you can actually choose to use a screwdriver. So you want to reach in and push it down until you hear it click and release. Now, grab your graphics card and slowly wiggle it out. If it feels like it's stuck, the clip may have come back up again, so you want to reach in and push it down. To reinstall your graphics card or insert your new graphics card, line it up with the PCIe slot on your motherboard. Once you've done that, you just want to check that these metal brackets on the back here are also lined up and they're going to slide down the side of your motherboard. If your new graphics card is actually larger than the other graphics cards you've removed, you might also have to remove an extra metal PCI bracket. So once it's all lined up, simply push it into place very carefully and you will hear it click and your motherboard will now hold it safely. Now it's time to redo those screws and replug the power cables. Personally, I like to redo the screws first because I think that it helps to give the graphics card a little bit of extra support when you're plugging those cables. The power cables will have an 8-pin or a 6-pin, so make sure that you have the correct cables lined up for each slot. Some power cables also have the 6-pin and a little kind of 2-pin separate, so you want to make sure those are lined up correctly and held together as you push them into the graphics card. The That's it, you've successfully reseated or installed your graphics card. Plug everything back in and enjoy your new GPU, or hopefully this fixed your display problem. If unfortunately you need to RMA your graphics card and need something to use in the meantime, or if you just finally want to upgrade and get the FPS you deserve, head over to the Overclockers website and check out the full graphics card range. Also, if you love the look of the pre-built system we used in this video, we'll pop a link in the description below. Thank you, I hope this video helped you out, and I'll see you in the next one.